Perseus Mining is Jeff Quartermaine and its Group Sustainability Manager, Jess Volich. Jess, good morning. Good to see you.
Morning.
Jeff, you've put out your 2020 Sustainable Development Report this morning. Talk us through some of the key highlights, what you're most proud of.
Well, look, thanks, Andrew. Firstly, you're absolutely right about our 2020 Sustainability Report. It's a very comprehensive piece of work that highlights a high level of detail about our approach to managing ESG, the results that we've achieved to date, and it also gives an insight into where we're going on this journey. Now, late last year, Perseus appointed my colleague Jessica, who's with me today, as head of sustainability. And Jess has been the author-in-chief of this very impressive report. So it's perhaps more appropriate that I defer to Jess to answer your question in detail. Jess?
Thanks, Jeff. Thanks, Andrew. Our primary aim in putting together this report was to really provide a clear picture of how Perseus is performing on sustainability and ESG, and clearly articulating our current position, including in comparison to our peers. So putting together this report, we applied best practice reporting frameworks, including the World Gold Council Responsible Gold Mining Principles, the Global Reporting Initiative, and the Sustainability Accounting Standards Board requirements. We'll also be releasing as part of this report our first Task Force on Climate-Related Financial Disclosures report, which details our climate change risks and opportunities. And I think what this work has really confirmed with great clarity is that all the work that Perseus has done over the years to build social license and manage sustainability risks and also harness the opportunities has today led to a really solid environmental and social performance. And I think that is what Perseus is most proud of. I think the performance highlights for us, we're really proud that we've had zero fatalities in the history of our company, and that we've improved our safety performance year on year. We've also increased year on year the significant benefits for our host communities. We're really proud that at the end of calendar year 20, 96% of our employees were from our host countries of Ghana and Cote d'Ivoire. We also sourced nearly 80% of our goods and services from within our host countries. And as the company's grown, so has the economic and social benefits to our host countries, which is definitely something to be proud of.
Jess, as Jeff said right at the start there, you've recently taken on this role of head of sustainability. So what's your vision for Perseus?
I think with the strong foundations that have already been established, Perseus is really well positioned to amplify its social value through more targeted social programs in line with our host country's plans to advance their progress towards the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. We're currently working on our three-year sustainability roadmap, and we'll release that with our next sustainability report. And I really look forward to updating you as this roadmap develops.
Jeff, if we can bring you back in, how do you see these sustainable practices adding value to Perseus and for your shareholders?
Well, it's an interesting matter, actually, Andrew, and it's a question that you could spend an awful lot of time responding to. I mean, for Perseus, the implementation of sustainable business practices has been one of our guiding principles for a very long time. So dealing with the ESG space is not a new phenomenon for us. And the reason why we've done this is quite simple. Without sustainable business practices, you can't expect to have a functioning social license to operate. And particularly in the part of the world where we operate, where we are guests in other people's countries and communities, if you don't have a social license to operate, frankly, you don't have a business. So it's really, really that simple. But if I was to sort of to cite a specific example of where our practices have added real value, we don't have to look any further than what's occurred in the last 12 months, and particularly in the area of occupational health and safety as it applied during the current COVID crisis. By adopting the standards and protocols that we have done, we've kept our employees safe and healthy all the way through. And that's meant that we've been able to run our business virtually uninterrupted for the entire period of time and for the benefit of shareholders. And not only that, of course, it's also well known that during this period, we've also managed to build our third mine, Yaouré, ahead of schedule and under budget. So, you know, while we were looking after our employees, we were also at the same time able to extend a lot of help into our local communities. And while we were unable to totally prevent infection around our mines, I believe that our efforts materially reduced the impact of COVID on our local community. So in a sense, everybody benefited. And this is a good example of a very important point I'd like to make. ESG is not a winner-takes-all game. Done properly, it can definitely be a win-win situation with all of our stakeholders benefiting, not just our shareholders. And this is what Perseus is seeking to do. And I trust that the report that we published today will provide readers with an excellent insight into the progress that we've been making to date. And it's with real pleasure that we've been able to distribute that today. And we would recommend to all listeners to carefully read the document and to engage with us in the future if there are any questions.
Good to see you, Jeff. And nice to meet you, Jess. Thanks very much indeed.
Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew.